Your time's up. We still have 10 minutes left in our session, I said while looking inquisitively at Benjamin as he colored away at a picture of Spider-Man. This caught me by surprise as I typically have to tell him it's time to head back out to the lobby to go home with his dad. Benjamin started coming to me around Christmas last year after he lost his mom. Some days he talks. Other days he colors in silence for the 45 minutes we have together each day. Your time's up, he emphasized again as he stared at me with his deep blue eyes. So much pain and heartache thrown on him at such a young age. Are you ready to leave? I asked as I started to feel a tinge of anxiety rise up in my throat. Something about the way he stared in silence made me grow uncomfortable. You are now. He responded in a barely audible whisper. Something about the way he spoke made the hairs on the back of my neck stand. Why is he acting this way? He's normally so sweet when he does decide to speak. I'll go ahead and let him go. What's a few minutes? I helped him put on his jacket, and lead him back out to the lobby to meet his dad. Has everything been okay at home? I asked as Ben walked over towards another child in the waiting room. About as good as it can be given the circumstances. Mark replied in a noticeably sad tone. My heart went out to the both of them. I couldn't imagine the pain they've both been through. I am seeing some improvement. I said with a half smile to try to end the day on a more positive note. Mark thanked me, and I walked back into my office and sat silently at my desk for a moment. He's just projecting onto you. I thought to myself over Ben's strange behavior. What did he mean that my time was up? I logged off my computer, grabbed my jacket and bag, and headed home. Your time's up. I looked up and met my husband's gaze. What did you just say? I glanced at the clock on the wall, 12:45. I said, let's go upstairs to bed. You fell asleep on the couch. Zachary smiled warmly at me. He grabbed my hand and helped me off the couch. Oh yeah, right, sorry. His smile slowly disappeared as he read the concern on my face. You feeling okay? He said as he rubbed my back while we walked upstairs to the bedroom. I don't know why I'm still thinking about Benjamin's words during our session. He's 5. Lots of kids say unexplainable things without any meaning behind their words. I just told Zachary I had a weird dream, brushed it off and crawled into bed for the night. Your time's up. Panic rose in my throat as I stared at the barista. Ma'am? Here's your coffee, she said as she picked it up off the counter and put it in my line of vision. Sorry, thank you. I said, and quickly walked towards the table in the corner holding the cream and sugar. I was going to need extra energy today for my session with Benjamin. I added my extra 6 sugar packets to my coffee, and grabbed a stir stick. I stared as I watched the sugar swirl and dissolve into my coffee. I was quickly pulled out of my trance as I realized the two girls sitting at a table near me were watching me. I met eyes with them and felt goosebumps rise on my arms. They both had unbearably large grins on their faces, and their pupils seemed to take over their entire eyes. I couldn't look away. Our eyes stayed locked on each other for what felt like hours. Then their lips started to move. Slowly at first. Like they were twitching that grew into wild, silently flailing movements. They looked inhuman. I started to back towards the wall, still in a trance as their lips moved wildly while their bodies stayed still. Still a huge creepy smile on their face. Still with soulless black eyes. Your time's up. Rang again and again but sounded as if it were inside my head. I let out a piercing scream to try to deafen the words. Ma'am? I suddenly snapped back into reality. H, here's your coffee. Do you need me to call someone? I'm standing in front of the barista. She looked at me with darting, confused eyes as I had just screamed in her face. I quickly looked over at the girl sitting in the corner. They stared in horror at the scene I just made, the smile gone from their faces and the color back in their eyes. I quickly grabbed my coffee and headed for the office. Your time's up. The words stopped me in my tracks and I quickly turned around to face my boss. You're running late, and you have 4 sessions today. I apologized to Laura without an excuse and walked to my office. The day went by in a haze until my last session of the day walked through the door. Benjamin. He smiled warmly at me as he sat down in his favorite chair and pulled out his coloring books. I couldn't help but watch him cautiously as he seemed unaware of the toll his words had taken on me over the last 24 hours. I let him color while I reviewed our notes from our previous sessions. I looked up and tried my best to smile, but he must have caught the unpleasant look on my face as his smile was replaced by a frown. So Ben, what do you want to do during our session today? I asked, trying to get the ball rolling. The faster we get this over with, the faster I can go home. He continued to frown at me and looked back down at his drawing. Looks like we aren't talking today. Fine by me. 20 minutes had passed as he sat coloring away while I watched him from my desk. I finally broke the silence. I had to bring up yesterday's session. Hey Ben? Is it okay if I ask you a question? His coloring came to a halt and he quickly looked up at me with his big blue eyes. Why did you say my time is up yesterday? Was it because we were almost done for the day? I said in a light-hearted tone, trying to mask the horrible feeling I had. He continued to stare at me, as he picked up his crayons and began to draw. His knuckles grew white as he gripped his crayon so tight I thought he'd snap it in half. I could visibly see his breathing growing heavier as he continued to violently scrape the crayon on the page. Hey Benjamin, it's okay, you don't have to answer that. He continued to stare at me as he started to make small tears in the paper. Ben. That's enough. You need to put the crayon down. As quickly as he started, he stopped and his eyes met the more than likely unrecognizable drawing on the paper. We sat in silence for the remainder of the session, his eyes locked on his drawing. Okay Ben. Looks like it's time to go meet your dad. He got up, and I helped him put on his jacket and walked him back out to meet his dad. I had to tell Mark what was happening. I asked if we could talk in my office in private, and he happily agreed. I explained Ben's strange behavior and what he had said to me. Mark laughed it off in an uncomfortably forced manner and told me that kids say the darndest things, shook my hand and promptly walked back to the lobby to get Ben. Why the hell is everyone acting so weird? I turned back to where Ben was sitting and saw he forgot his drawing. Shit. I walked towards the table and felt the unease creep up through my body. I slowly made my way up to the drawing. Trembling hands, I turned the paper around and felt the blood drain from my face. Scribbled over and over again were the words "Your time's up." I sprint down the steps of my office building out into the rain. I've gotta get home. I look around at the busy streets and cars racing past me. I head north into a crowd of umbrellas and rain jackets to get back to my apartment building. From off behind me I hear it. Your time's up. It's coming after me. My time is up. I gotta get home. I have to tell Zachary I loved him. I look behind me in hopes I could see how far back it is. Your time's up. It's in front of me. I turn around and slam myself into an oncoming stranger, knocking the newspapers she carried out of her hands and into the puddled rain on the sidewalk. I quickly bent down to try to salvage at least one of the newspapers, and my attention went to its headline. December 7th marks 1 year anniversary of the death of Benjamin and his father, local hero Corporal Mark McFarlane. Memories flood my mind like a bloody waterfall. I'm suddenly in my car. Driving. On my cell arguing with customer service over a package I hadn't received. I pull my phone from my ear to look at my calendar to see when the package was ordered and I suddenly feel the impact of bodies hitting the front of my car. I slam on my brakes after I made it over the second bump in the road. Smoke rose around my car as I frantically looked in my mirrors to see what I hit. That's when I saw it. The bodies. Two lifeless bodies laying in the crosswalk. Crowds gathering around to see the damage I've done. I ran the red light. Their time's up. Your time's up. I looked up at the old TV sitting in front of me in the blindingly white room. What? I said as I looked to the woman named Laura dressed in all burgundy standing beside me. Your time's up. It's Zachary's turn to watch TV. It's time to take your medicine and go back to your room.